For anything like me, you've likely heard of this interesting little thing called music. Furthermore, I bet you've also heard of a new fad called artificial intelligence that's single-handedly destroying and corrupting the art industry as we know it. First off, let's find out what exactly AI music is and how it's made. Obviously, music is not one single method of expression, but a multitude of unique elements that come together to form what we'd call a song. As such, there are many different things that artificial intelligence can do with regard to making music, including melody generation, songwriting, timbre rendering, and more. For the purpose of this video, we'll be focusing mostly on melody generation, since that's often the most impactful and memorable part of a given song. There are many methods for generating music with AI, and in this video, we'll only be covering a few. First is evolution. This method uses a genetic algorithm to generate compositions by restricting the allowed notes to a particular key and range of durations. The notes are represented as tuples containing the pitch and duration, and the songs are then represented as strings of these tuples, with the initial population containing many randomly generated compositions. The problem with this method is that music is subjective, so creating an objective and benevolent fitness function is impossible. The most obvious solution to this is to use a hybrid approach, where each individual in a generation would be listened to and evaluated by a human auteur. However, I'm sure you could imagine manually listening to hundreds or thousands of these songs every generation would get tiresome very quickly. Alternatively, a neural network can be trained to detect and evaluate specific genres of music based on the standards of that genre. So the fitness function can be trained to evaluate fitness of an individual on the basis of its jazziness, poppiness, countryness, etc. Next, this is Alicia. She is a music co-creation tool that takes lyrics as inputs and generates melodies to go with them. Inside of Alicia is two models, a rhythm model and a melody model, both of which are trained in the same way. The training is done with a large dataset of music XML files, each of which relates a single instrument and vocal line to an accompanying lyric. Firstly, the set of features are extracted from the XML files. Then the two models are trained using Random Forest, which I will briefly explain. Random Forest is a decision tree machine learning algorithm that utilizes many random trees to prevent overfitting. A random subset of features are selected, then the feature in that subset that splits the dataset most purely is chosen as a root node, and so on and so on. This process is repeated a predefined number of times. At the end of training, you're left with a forest of decision trees. The model then works by taking a majority vote among all the trees. After training, lyrics are fed into the rhythm and melody models, which in conjunction generate a composition that goes with them. Of course, this is a hideous oversimplification of how Alicia really works, but for the sake of brevity, I'll leave it at that. The last method I'll discuss is deep learning, more specifically, hierarchical recurrent neural networks. HRNNs can be used to generate music by using the layers and overall structure of the hierarchy to encode the music theory and principles used in whatever genre of music you'd like to generate, as shown here. In this instance, the key and press layers encode what pitch is being played and the duration of that key press, and the chord and drum layers generate a chord and drum pattern based on the melody created by the key presses. The hierarchy works as follows. For generating a key, a two-layer LSTM is used to pick one of 12 notes over 3 octaves or silence based on a probability function generated from the previous key as well as some auxiliary information, which is then one-hot encoded and passed along to the next key layer time step as well as the press layer. In the press layer, another two-layer LSTM is used to generate a number between 1 and 8 representing how long the key will be held, based of course on the key at that time step and the press duration from the previous time step. For chords, a two-layer LSTM is used to choose one of 72 chords based on the current key and press duration and the previous chord generated. This comes from the discovery that in the pop music dataset used for training, over 99% of all chords were one of 6 types over 12 starting notes. Finally, in the drum layer, they shake it up and use a random number generator to create a drum track. Just kidding. A two-layer LSTM is used to pick one of 100 one-bar long drumming patterns based on all of the previous layers as well as the drumming pattern used in the previous time step. After all that mess is done, the layers and time steps are combined to create a unique composition with a melody, drums, and chords. Okay, what were we talking about? Oh yeah, is AI music art? Well, music is subjective, and art is as well, which makes that a pointless question.